Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the bones, or the osteology of the lower limb. As with much of this session, much of this is an introduction to begin to familiarize yourself with the basic players in this region, and we will continue to add detail as we work through the upcoming sessions. Let us start proximally and work our way distally, and this first bone I hope you feel is a review as we have covered it in other areas, and this is the coxal or hip bone, which of course is paired. This bone is often discussed in the three parts that develop and will eventually fuse. There is the superior, more fan-shaped ilium, which is shaded in light blue here. The posterior and robust ischium that is shaded in orange. So you can see a bit of it from this anterior view. And the smallest and most anteriorly placed pubis, which is shaded in green in these images. And these two pubis bones will articulate at the pubic symphysis, which is located right here. All three of these parts will fuse during childhood in this fairly deep socket-shaped region. This whole region here is referred to as the acetabulum. The acetabulum faces laterally, and this will receive the head of the femur to form the hip joint, so a very important region of this bone. Speaking of the femur, let's discuss this longest bone of the body. This is the bone of the thigh, and is quite robust in both its proximal, so this is proximal, and distal portions. The major structure I want to point out proximally on the femur today is the head of the femur. This is the ball in the ball and socket joint formed at the hip, and it will articulate or join with the acetabulum that we saw in this previous slide. So there's a pretty good fit there in terms of those structures. On its distalmost end, there are the condyles. So I'm going to circle both here, of which there are two. There's a medial and a lateral. Now, how do I know which one is medial and which one is lateral? That is always the question. How are we going to be able to identify these? For me, the easiest way is to look at which one is on the same side as the head. So which one is on the same side as the head? Well, it's this one right here. So this one is going to be the medial. The head of the femur must be medially placed in order to articulate with the acetabulum of the coxal bone. Therefore, this is the medial condyle, and this is the lateral condyle. Also of note, we are looking at a posterior view of the femur, mainly because this affords the clearest picture of the condyles. You can really see how bulbous they are from this view, and that is less true from an anterior view. Moving to the patella, these are the largest sesamoid bones in the body. A sesamoid bone is a bone that forms within a tendon, and this is certainly the case of the patella, which forms in the tendon of the quadriceps femoris muscle, or the quads, in the anterior thigh. The patella is the bone that you can feel when you're touching the anterior portion of your knee region. It's pretty distinct looking, with a rougher looking anterior side. So this is anterior. And a smoother articular posterior side. This is the portion, this is the side that will articulate with the femur. Moving to the bones of the leg, similar to what we have in the forearm of the upper limb, there are two bones. The more medial of the two is the tibia. So the tibia is the medial one. And this bone is considerably thicker, larger than its lateral counterpart, the fibula, and it's the major weight bearer of the leg. The proximal portion of the tibia is the portion that's involved with the knee joint, and this entire superior region, so kind of this whole region right about here, is referred to, it also has these articular surfaces that you can see from this superior view here. This region right here is called the tibial plateau. And on the tibial plateau, you will have the condyles, and these will articulate with the femoral condyles we saw in the previous picture. Now, I wouldn't ask you to tell me which one is which one's medial and which one's lateral here. But I did put this image in here because I wanted to show you just how shallow these condyles are. So think about how loose that fit is between the femoral condyles, which had these fairly bulbous condyles right here, fitting in this extremely shallow area here. So the stability of the knee joint is not so much coming from the fit of the bones. Now, when you are looking at a complete view of the tibia, you can get an idea of which one is medial and which is lateral. And that's by looking at this structure on the opposite or distal end of the tibia, called the medial malleolus or malleolus. You'll hear it either way. The medial malleolus is, as its name would suggest, medial. And it's pretty hard to miss. If you put your hand on the medial side of your ankle region, that is the bump you feel on the medial side. So if you can find the medial malleolus, you have a pretty good idea of which one is the medial condyle, and this would be the lateral condyle, so that shallow area right here. Now, the lateral and much thinner counterpart in the leg is the fibula. When looking at an isolated fibula, as we are here, it can be difficult to tell which side is superior and which side is inferior, as these portions of the bone look relatively similar. My best advice is that the head of the fibula, which is this superior portion here, is less tapered. It's a slightly more bulbous, whereas the lateral malleolus or malleolus is going to be on the distal end, and it certainly is more tapered. Also, it'd be pretty mean of us to give you an image that is upside down. So this is going to be more superiorly placed, whereas this will be more inferiorly placed. If you palpate the lateral side of your ankle area, you are touching the lateral malleolus. Now, finally, we have reached the ankle and foot region. We are looking at a view of the dorsal foot. So if you were to look straight down at the tops of your feet, that is a dorsal view. There are 7 tarsal bones, which are shaded in green here. So one less than what we had with the carpal bones, but certainly relatively larger than the carpal bones. And we do want you to be able to differentiate 2 of the tarsal bones. The most superior of the tarsals is the talus, or the talus, you'll hear it either way, which is the tarsal bone that plays a role in the ankle joint. And just inferior to the talus is the largest tarsal bone, which is the calcaneus. Sometimes you hear this referred to as the heel bone. It is identifiable or easily identifiable just due to its size. And you do not have to memorize the names of these other tarsal bones, but here are the rest of those right here. There are 5 metatarsals organized from 1 through 5, from medial to lateral. And these are shaded in orange here. I know this is medial because this is associated with the great toe. You can see that these bones here are a little bit kind of more solid and robust. So this would be your first metatarsal, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th. So first will always be the more medial and associated with your great toe or big toe. Shaded in pink are the proximal phalanges. Light purple are the middle or intermediate phalanges. Notice that there is not a middle phalange associated with the first digit. And lastly, in light blue, these are the distal phalanges. And notice that the more lateral you get in terms of the distal phalanges, they become quite small and not particularly well developed. So those are the bones of the lower limb in a nutshell. And with an image with them all together, I kind of wanted to go through them once more to make sure that we're on the same page regarding location. So starting proximally, we have the coxal bones here close to the trunk. This is your sacrum right here. The ilium is going to be more superiorly placed. The ischium is not as easy to see here because it's mainly in a posterior view. You can see a little bit of it right here. And then the pubis are going to be the smallest ones that are more anteriorly placed. So those are the coxal bones. You can even see a bit of the acetabulum right here. So that's going to be the acetabulum. And that's going to articulate with the head of the femur. So femur here, of course, this is the unpaired, there's only one femur associated with each thigh. Distally, you will have the medial and the lateral condyles. So you can see the medial is going to be here. The lateral, you can't see quite as well, but it would be over here. This is a good image for seeing where the patella articulates with the femur. So here's your patella here, very anteriorly placed. The tibia, when we're looking at the leg, is clearest in this particular image with the tibial plateau kind of up in this region here, and the medial malleolus or malleolus here. You can barely see the fibula in this image, and this is because the leg has been rotated a little medially and the fibula is so thin that even with a slight bit of rotation there, you almost lose complete view of it. You can see a little peak of the lateral malleolus right here and even over here in this image. You can see the talus here that is going to articulate with the lower ends of the tibia and the fibula. And the rest of the tarsal bones, you have metatarsals here, and then all of the phalanges, which are your distalmost bones associated with the lower limb. Excellent. Thank you for your time and attention here. Please always feel free to reach out with any questions, and I hope you have an excellent rest of your day.